Hello there. Yes, it's a big box. It's the breeding box of the pair of Dynastes Hercules. That was in this box for about 1 month. And 2 weeks ago, I took the female and the male out. Now they are in another box, and probably, and I hope so, the female will go on there with the egg-laying process. And now it's time to have a look whether we find some eggs or larvae inside of the box. If you have a look in the playlist, and if you go back 2 steps, you will see how I have prepared the box around 7 weeks ago. And then you will also see and realize that the box has changed a lot during the time the pair was in here, because 7 weeks ago it was filled to the rim with substrate, and now it's compacted practically to not the half, a bit more than half. It just compressed very heavily, and we have a look what happens in here. Of course, first I have to take out all the things that have been left behind from the beetles, all of these beetle jellies here. There were a lot, and they eat also a lot, these beetles. They are, sometimes they can eat 1 to 2 beetle jellies in a day when they are very hungry or they need a lot of humidity. Then they can eat a lot. So, and then of course I need a place where I can put the substrate. And of course, what I need too are small boxes to put the larvae or the eggs in when I see them. And there's a different techniques to do that. In a lot of books, it's written that you should prepare the box like this, that you make a little hole on the side of the box down. On the side of the box, and that you put the eggs inside of these holes so that you can see from outside whether the egg has hatched or not. So I will make this as an experiment, just to see whether it works or not. Now here there could be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 larvae in there, but of course I would be glad if there's only one. I don't know yet at the moment whether there is any larvae or egg in here in this substrate. I hope, of course, so. And the other technique is that I do the same like with goliotus, that I just make a hole, compressed the middle part of the box a little bit, and put the larvae with a little bit, or the egg with a little bit of the original material from the box inside of this hole, and cover it then again. So now let's have a look whether we find something, because this is not said that that there's always that the females start laying eggs as soon as you put them into the breeding container. That's not not always the case. So I also have put some big chunks of rotten wood into the substrate. It's said that the females like it if they realize that there is a lot of white rotten wood in the box. They think it could be a good substrate to lay eggs. And let's have a look whether we find something. What we find is a lot of leftover beetle jellies, of course. So mostly they don't lay the eggs on the surface of the substrate, but dig down and compress it. It's really very hot down here. It's like concrete. So, yeah, there's another piece of a log that I put into the substrate. And of course, now I have to check all these little compressed pieces in the substrate for eggs, because often the females, they lay their eggs into kind of compressed pieces of substrate. And now of course we have to carefully search through the whole substrate and have a look whether we find something in here. Would be nice if we can find something. And if not, here is, no, what's that? No, it's not an egg. It's a, it looks like an egg, but it's not. It's just a piece of sand, I think. Yeah, okay. Oh, but here I see something. Yeah, it's, I have to dig it out and let's just put it under there. So, look, I've seen something here. What is that? Let's have a look whether it's an egg of Dynastes Hercules or whether it's already a larvae. No, it's an egg. Yes, it is. Here it is. Yeah, perfect egg of Dynastes Hercules. How big is it? It's around 5 millimeters in diameter. That's a pretty big one. So what do I do? The first one now I put into this solo box. Just some of the old substrate, minus the worms, of course. I don't really like them. Then I make a little hole where I can put the egg in. Then I carefully take the egg, put it into this hole. Cover it with substrate, of course. At this time also I have to see that there are no worms in here. Bit of the original substrate, water, so that's wet enough for the egg to that they can absorb water from the substrate. That's why they get big, get bigger and bigger during the hatching process. But it's nice that I have seen one, so I know that the female, yeah, look here, that's very typical. It's a big egg in a little cave that the female has prepared. That it's a little cave here, cavity in the substrate, and there she put the egg in. It's also it's also pretty big. It's also around 5 millimeters. So what I do, pay attention that you don't lose too much time while preparing the container, so because they don't, that they can't dry out in that. If you let them just lay around like that, that's not good for the egg. So now I have to put it carefully into one of these holes. Yes, and cover it with a little of the original substrate. So that's this technique that was, that is often shown from Japanese breeders. So this, the idea is that you can see the egg here and you can have a look to the progress of the egg from outside. Well, that would be an easy technique too, because you don't need so many containers for them. The search has begun, and there's another egg here. Look, the search has begun. Next cavity here, next hole. So cover it. Now I've already found three of them. Now that can last now for another half an hour. If you start seeing eggs, you must go through the substrate very carefully. But I'm glad to see that the female really started laying eggs here in that substrate. So we'll make a short break and come back after this and show you the result of my search here. Now this was the last egg now that I put in here. I cover it with a little bit of original material. So now that's finished now. I'm through with the whole box. 65 liters of substrate was in here. So, and how many eggs did I find? I didn't find any larvae, only eggs, but I put 7 in each box here. If we look a little bit from closer, we can see that in every little hole is one egg here. One is here. One is here. 2 times 7 is 14. And here are 4 18, 19 eggs. This female laid 19 eggs in around 1 month that she was in the box. So probably we can leave her a little bit longer in there. She's laying an egg every second day. That's, I think, normal for Dynastes Hercules. Thanks for watching.